Hi everyone and welcome to the HWBOT World Tour 2016 in Europe. I'm Trouffman from OverclockingTV and I've been joined by Timothee, Xyala from HWBOT. How are you doing, my friend?
Hey Truff, how's it going? Very good.
Very good, thank you. And we are here tonight for a very special show that's going to be a tech talk Q&A here on OverclockingTV. And we will be unveiling something we have been teasing you for the past 2 weeks. And that's going to be quite interesting. This is the Open Benchtable project. And so for the next hour, you will be able to ask us any question regarding this project and we'll be presenting you exactly what it was this about. Timothee, let's get to it. So first of all, what is this project to start
with? So it started actually already quite some time ago, like maybe a good year and a half. So the idea is that we couldn't find on the market any bench table that is actually, good enough for overclockers that are traveling around and they need to take something in their backpack that is not too heavy, that is still very useful and practical, where you can put stuff under the table and not just, you know, some people just take actually just a top plate of some bench table and just use that. So we needed something that was usable, basically. So we started
transportable.
So that's how we started it. And what we wanted also is to make a table that people can easily customize, where they can develop some accessories for it, no matter what kind of use they have. So nothing on the market was actually corresponding to the needs we have, and that's how we ended up creating that Open Benchtable project. So we started working with some people in the industry. The first project didn't really work out, and then last year at Computex we met with the guys from STREACOM, and then we started really talking about the design with them, and they have some awesome designers that worked on the design of that table with all the specs we actually wanted to get for it. And also knowing that STREACOM is specialized in
super high-end aluminium cases,
so in cases made out of aluminium, then that's it. That's how we went with it.
That's pretty much how this came up. So this is it, guys. For the past 2 weeks, we have been teasing you for on a website called openbenchtable.com. And with this one, you guys have been registering for more information. We are now ready to unveil what this is. We had some of the picture on our Facebook fan page, Open Space Benchtable. You can find it on Facebook, facebook.com/openbenchtable. That's where we are giving all the information. We had a sneak peek today about what we are using and how we're using it. Now it's time to do it completely. So Timothee, first of all, before going too much into the details, the only thing we can see now is this. That's the box. So this is the box where we have the precious inside. It's been a while. We have been looking for something that could fit our purpose and our needs, and we do think that this one will be okay. But before going to unveil that, first we have to say these are prototypes. It's not final product yet. These are still in a development at the moment. We want to unveil that to you guys because it's been. And we have been gathering information from the community for the past year and a half, pretty much, trying to find out what you guys would love as overclocker or reviewers to have as a bench table. This is still prototype. We are still taking feedbacks for it. So if you have any comments or any idea that you want to see, like taking lives, you're more than welcome to let us know on the live chat. So Timothee, I think we can just unveil what this is first, and then we can go step by step into seeing why we did it this way.
Okay, sure. So let's do the live unboxing then. So I already cut open the seal so you guys can see it. I will open the box, which is right in front of the camera, so it's not going to be very practical. But don't worry, I'm going to remove the box, so just give me a second. I'm taking it out. So. Ooh, some people might see some stuff here.
So these fit a complete bench table. So if you guys have any idea about the regular bench table, this is super, super small. Are you guys ready for it?
Da-da-da-da-da-da. There you go. So basically it's the size of a laptop, a little bit larger maybe, but the width is about the same. So I'm going to remove the cover here. Okay, so Basically, the cool thing about it is that it's made out of one single piece of aluminium. The legs fold back into the table. And so you have two pieces of acrylic on both sides closing the table. So I guess the best is now to just open it up. So there's some screws here. We're still working on the best way to open and close the table. So these are things that we are actually collecting feedback during the events and improving things. We already had a little feedback round internally when we got the very, very first prototype, which was actually quite similar to that one because the Streacom guys made such an amazing job on the design that it's actually really good from the start already. So yeah, we are adding more screws here and there, adding a little bit of extra things. So one last screw. So basically you remove four screws. Initially it only had two, but actually four just closes it better. It keeps the acrylic in place. So once you've done removing your screws, so you can remove that plate. There's a second use of this plate actually. You could we use it in the workshop PCs. We just flip it around and put it like that. So we can close it off. And it means if you don't use all your screws, you can still mount your motherboard without the middle screw and lock down the screws in the compartments in there. So okay, so you remove the plate and all the screws are actually stored in those little gaps here. So
let's go over the screw that we can get into that in that one. So these are still prototypes. Yeah. The screws are not final, but we have a good idea about what we can get with this.
Okay, yeah, so those are just regular standoffs. Well, not just regular, they're slightly higher. They're 2 centimeters high. The screws, there's enough of them to use a full ATX motherboard with all the screws. Basically, the idea is that eventually we will provide those ones plus the clip-on ones. So standoffs that have already like little heads here, so you can actually clip on your motherboard, similar to some other benchtable on the market, which is something that is pretty useful. Right now, most of the existing benchtable have really tight ones, which is not great because when you pull off the motherboards, you actually bend it a little bit. So we are working on making those with a little head a little bit better than what there is out there for the moment, so that's still a work in progress. We don't want to use the plastic one because plastic is kind of, you know, not awesome.
Plastic is kind of outdated in a way.
We do have some plastic here, but you know, it's okay. So I'm just gonna remove all those because we don't need them at the moment. And in that compartment we also have the motherboard screws. So right now we use those plastic ones. We also tested some metallic ones that are here. So those are basically thumb screws. There's two different types of them. Those are for motherboards, those are for the SSD drives. Ideally, we will end up with actually only one type of screws. We are still working on choosing, do we go for something a bit higher on the head like that or something like this. Okay, here we have plastic, maybe we should use something else, you know. So those are two discussions that we still have. So, yeah. So I'm gonna remove those as well. And we'll see after the other compartment.
But that was just the first part of the compartment. So you can see that it fits a lot of useful stuff inside. So you could have pretty much all the standoffs for your motherboard in just one part for it.
Yes, correct. So the other one, we have those highest standoffs that are actually 4 centimeters high. And guess what? Graphics card, 2x4. So you can put them like that. So you can either use them to have your motherboard high up. Or you put them like this, and you can use it as a standoff for the graphics card. Alright, so... Oh, a standoff for the graphic. Actually, it replaced the PCI Express mount of your chassis.
Yeah. So that's actually the one of the issues with the bench table. Usually you don't have the backside to actually screw the graphics cards to it.
So either you use the OC brace, the Gigabyte OC brace, if you have a Gigabyte motherboard, but if you don't, then, well... fitting in the design here, the actually complete sized one was not so practical, so we used two standoffs. It's kind of modular. It's not the best at the moment, but it's kind of nice to have those. We might make them round so they're gonna be more designed. It's all about right now having something very practical and kind of easy to pack. So just gonna take
at
them
the
out.
Moment the goal is to get something useful, not the
exactly,
design.
Yeah.
Actually you can see that the design of the benchtable is quite advanced already.
Yes.
Just the screws and the extra stuff, we are still thinking about how we can improve that part. But the goal is it does the job, and that's what's most important at the moment.
Then the other screws you get are actually your leg screws. So eventually those will be the only screws that will be different from the other screws. So of course there's four of them. And then we have some screws for the SSD drives and some screws for your power supplies, because you know, power supplies like to have some kind of interesting mountings here. We'll show you later how that works. Okay, so I'm just taking it out. Okay, now so the cool part now are those legs. Those are cut out of the same piece of aluminium here. They're also anodized aluminium, so they're not gonna be corroding or anything. They're already prepped with the holes, all the possible holes you could need for power supplies. So actually most power supplies you just need to screw in three screws, but if you, depending the which power supply you have, you might actually can use four or use three on the other side, etc. So that's really to make it just more compatible. Cool thing also for transportation, truth, if you can zoom in, there's some small holders in there. So when you transport your table, so the aluminium doesn't bump from side to side, it goes like there and it locks the actual piece into place. So it's kind of a cool addition that the guys from STREACOM thought about. So that's actually really cool. All right, so I'm just removing the other piece here.
So you just pop them out from the bench table then?
Yeah, they're just sitting in there like that, so you just take them out. Or you could also flip the whole table, they would fall off, but I just make it in a nice way, you know? Okay, so now we've got the table here. Of course, the other part goes off. Actually, I could remove it, so we can just have it ready on both sides. Just a few more screws in here. So of course, don't make the mistake. Just remove the four screws that you need. Don't remove the screws of the holders. So again, those parts, you don't have to remove them. If you actually plan to use LN2, you might want to keep them under because they're going to help to avoid having air coming from under your motherboard. But if you're planning to have cables coming from the PCU through those holes back to the motherboard, you might want to remove the acrylic.
That's pretty much like a personal taste if you want to use them or not then.
Yeah, for workshops we leave them and we just flip them around so we can keep screws that we don't use in there so we don't lose screws. But yeah, you can use them as you wish. You know, having the two layers is just extra insulation if you're doing LN2 or something, so yeah. So basically you end up with something like that. So that's the actual plate of the bench table. So the first thing you need to do then is to actually mount the legs, of course.
Before mounting the leg, let's talk a little bit more about the piece. This is one big piece of aluminium.
Yep.
It's been anodized to look like this and to be fresh. I tell you guys, like, these are prototypes. They are straight out of the factory. We just got them just a few days before the event here. Actually, we got them the day of the event. And so if we look at that, it's like one piece of aluminium. How thick is it for now?
Okay, so this one is 1 centimeter thick. It is about 2.2 kilos, 2.5 kilos if you include the whole packaging and everything. It is still fairly heavy. That's something we're still discussing, if we make it thinner and how it's going to be actually stable enough with the legs. The difficulty is to be able to actually drill holes in there that are going to be solid enough to actually maintain the table properly without having any issues of wearing off after a long period of time. But this table can actually take the load of a system like an ATX motherboard with all the DIMM slot populated, 4 graphics card, 4 GPU pods.
Everything under LN2, right?
4 slims plus a fat GPU CPU pod. So it can take the load of about 25 to 30 kilos, no problem.
That's insane. That's more than what most of the people will use.
Yeah, it's more than necessary, of course. So that's why we are maybe considering other options to make it a little bit lighter. But yeah, there's also the, of course, we can always make it lighter by getting material removed here and there. So we're still thinking of how we could use the space removed like we did here for the legs. So everything we remove, we want to make something useful out of it. So that's something we are still discussing with the guys from STREACOM. Cool thing also, engraving on the aluminium. I don't know if you close up. So of course we've got our logos here because we're working all together and we love it. But also we can see it's a special HWBOT World Tour Edition. France 26th to 29th of March, the event we have here at Gamers Assembly. So there's only 12 pieces of them. So this is the unit 11 of 12. So they're all,
and that's the only pieces of the prototype that does exist in the world at the moment.
Yeah, so there's only 12 like those. I have one for myself, which is the very early one, piece one of two. So Streacom has the second original one, and so yeah, so we're trying to keep the numbers so like people know that it's something quite unique. There's actually four of them to be won here at Gamers Assembly. So there's two for the extreme guys and two for the amateurs. So if you guys want to join us at the LAN ETS in North America, there's also two to win there in the extreme competition and two for the amateur competition. So if you're interested, that's something cool.
And I don't know if you guys noticed, but in the back, this is here. That's our stream rig. We are actually using that that bench table at the moment, and it's been quite useful to set up the stream. So, Timothee, how do we fix the legs for it?
Okay, so it's very simple. There's just one trick. Keep those screws outlets outside. You can see here it's slightly larger for the head of the screw. So those have to be on the outside of the table. That's the only kind of trick you have to think about. So what do? You just pass your first screw here. You put your leg like that, and you just screw in the screw, right? Well, of course, you have to catch the right threading.
And that's the thing, they are straight out of the factory, so they've never been used before, never actually, been mounted.
Actually, this table has never been mounted before, so the threading was made in the factory, so it's still a little bit tight, but once you get the right grip, it's all good.
So these screws just grow through the bench table straight to the legs.
Yeah.
And this will keep it tight enough to sustain like 20-25 kilos of a complete system on top of it.
Yeah, you would think you would need more more reinforcements like you see on most of the steel-based bench table where you have to fold things and make round corners or right holders to kind of like hold the pressure, but it's not so much necessary. So it's kind of like easy to mount. It's quite sufficient. So you do that. Just tighten it well. Don't be actually scared on this one, because it's really important to put them properly, because otherwise they're gonna move a little bit and it will
and
wear
over
off.
Time, that's just yeah. So far we have been using them for the workshop.
Yeah.
We've been using them here for the stream rig for this weekend, and so far we had no issue at all, even on these prototypes. About the legs, so it's still quite robust at the moment to what we are trying to do.
Yeah, it's fairly solid, so we don't really have any complaints or anything on that.
So this project has been a joint project between HWBOT, Streacom, and Overclocking-TV. So basically, the idea in the back was from HWBOT and OCTV to do a bench table for a while to solve some of the issue that we have as traveling overclockers.
But we are not designers, so we needed help.
Indeed, and we are not we don't have industrial design knowledge as well. So something that Streacom was extremely extremely competent at doing that. They have extended knowledge on the manufacturing side, especially doing the aluminium casing that they do mostly for their own product. And so when the discussion came on, Streacom appeared to be the preferred partner to go for this. And we have to say that we did met some of the guys at Streacom that definitely deserve and were enthusiastic to work on this project with us. So we really appreciated the fact that indeed we can do this kind of project. It's always new, something completely new for us to design a product as well from the start, and of course that will never have been possible without the help of Streacom for that. So far the name, so the project name is the Open Benchtable, but the name reference for Streacom is BC1, so Benchtable 1.
Yeah, so Streacom is a partner in the manufacturing of that table, and you were discussing how could we actually call it. You know, you always need a reference in your catalog, and also a reference of how you call the table when you're gonna talk with your production lines and things like that. You know, you cannot tell them, oh, you know, it's the open bench table. You know, you need something a little bit more down to earth. So we actually ended up calling it BC1, which is something Streacom suggested, and basically it stands for BC1, For bench one, sorry. It stands for
BC
what it
one
says.
Stand for BC one. Okay.
This totally makes sense, right? Okay, so that screws is actually.
So that's the threading that is out of the factory. So keep in mind, guys, these are prototypes, and these prototypes are out of the factory. We see that you guys have a lot of comments right now on the live chat. We are trying to catch up on reading them as well. El Gap was saying full toolless will be awesome. Yes, that will be awesome indeed if we can just mount everything without the need of a screwdriver. That's the ultimate goal indeed, to not need anything. We still have to keep in mind that we need something that can be lightly packed. I saw a comment that, will these be sold at IKEA? Actually, the old thinking behind the bench table was, we need something that can be portable easily for all the overclockers that do travel a lot and that have a concern in volume and weight. So it's pretty much a ratio between the total volume of the product and the total weight of the product for it to work. There's some people that says that the standoff are actually a good idea as well for the VGA. So that's quite interesting to see that you guys love this. As I said, we are actually using that bench table for the stream rig, the one we are streaming with. We are using it right now with the standoff. So we have the PSU is hooked to the bench table. We're gonna get to that in a minute. We have the standoff and the motherboard put to it. We have one graphic card that is dual slot that is fixed with the standoff. We have a capture card and an extra USB card with the standoff. And it's been robust so far because we have been moving between here the location for the extreme overclocker and the other location that where we have the workshop, and we've just grabbed it like this and just move around with it, and it was completely fine, and completely stretched to it. Timothee?
Yep.
So what's happening? It's the still a prototype, so everything is still need to need some refining.
Oh yeah. So you know, it's the only way to actually really test a bench table or test any computer case for that matter is to actually really try it out in the field. So there's a lot of things we are thinking about. We are thinking as a possible improvements, you know, of how we could actually get more, make it, for example, like you guys said on the chat, faster to mount, something with as less screws as possible, something with, you know, less material maybe, something... Yeah, something that is just maybe even better than that already. So this is actually some things we are thinking about. We could spend almost hours discussing about what type of screws you're gonna need or the best screws that you could use to screw on your motherboard. And if you don't need a screw, okay, still, what is the best possible
standoff you could use? The best way to fix the motherboard and to keep it in position when you bench with the LN2. There was actually a comment regarding the fixation itself. But comment from Woody's Gun. I think this will be popular with non-traveler as well. It is very sleek for an open test bed. Yes, indeed. We did target at first people that are traveling, overclockers that do travel, because they are our core users and core target for most of what we are doing at Overclocking TV and HWBOT. But of course, the goal for this is to solve some of the issue that are inherent to the bench table in general. So as you can see, we have the holding, and if you guys saw on the Facebook page, this is actually part of the logo as well. It looks like a cutting board.
Yeah, actually that was one of the possible names as well, but it didn't make any sense, but it would have been a hilarious one.
So Timothee, what can we let's go discuss a little bit more about all the details that we have regarding that one. So guys on the live chat on Twitch, let us know what you guys want to see or want to know about this bench table. In the meantime, let's have a look at the picture we already did publish before on our Facebook fan page. So here you have the main logo for the bench table. Nice logo. It definitely looked like it. You just saw it on the live.
It's gonna be improved a little bit. it's gonna be.
That improved. Was the first revision of the logo. Of these. Yep. So now you can understand better why this was all blurred out, but now you can see it for real. And if we check out, this is actually the stream system that we are using here to stream this very show here on Twitch, on OverclockingTV. And as you can see, the standoff are being used with the graphic cards, the capture card, and the extra USB card.
Oh yeah,
and
so I said two before, but it's actually three of them.
Yeah, it's three. It's three up on to make them. Let's go and check out the chat. So guys, the God Eater said, "I will pay a nice premium if I could get this splash anodized." Anodization about aluminium, you can do pretty much any color you want.
Yeah.
The issue is the process to do it. If you do it just for one, might not be worth it.
Also,
that's the thing. That's why we are working with STREACOM, because on the on the designing side and the requirements, we know what we are aiming at, but on the manufacturing side, we don't have this knowledge. That's why STREACOM is so slow. They've been building that for years. They've been building high-end aluminum cases for years. So with their help and their knowledge, we are putting all our forces together to create this kind of product.
It's true. I know that this is a matte finish kind of. So it's just very very simple and sleek and kind of an elegant finish. If you feel it to your fingers, it's nice. It doesn't leave any fingerprints marks. And actually, if you have greasy finger, you don't really see it so much.
Tried to put Vaseline on top.
I'm not gonna try that. But if someone wants to do it, he can. After anodize, you could also have that very more brilliant, like a shiny finish. You could have different colors as well, like for example, we see on some LN2 ports from Kingpin or Roman, for example. So yeah, those are of course options. But yeah, so for this one, it's only gray for the moment. And I think right now we'll see how many people are interested. We probably will see how we do pre-orders and things like that for the table. But basically, depending of the amount of people interested, then we'll consider if it's actually interesting and worth doing more colors and more finish, or if we just keep doing it like that.
There's a lot of people actually on the live chat that says they will get one, like Mark 0053. Love this bench table and I will be buying one for sure. Guys, it's still a prototype, so we're still getting opinion to improve the design from what we have right now.
Oh, and one cool thing, I don't know if you can show on the camera if it's going to focus or not, but those standoffs, they actually have some, to not scratch the aluminium.
Joint.
They have some plastic joints are at the base. So basically when you screw them onto your table, so they're not going to leave any traces on the actual aluminium itself. So it's fine. It's kind of cool like that. So that's at the base here, if you see it. Maybe not. But cool addition from the guys from STREACOM. That was not on the first version of it. So as you can see, we are improving it. By the end of the world tour, it's going to be perfect.
So that means the end of the year, pretty much. Guys, we are taking a comment for the prototype. If you have any idea, let us know. If you want to see some features on it, let us know as well. It's going to be interesting to see what we can do with that and what the overclockers will be doing with this bench table, and how they can they can use that for their bench station.
There's also a comment from Gapo saying cut out radiators mount out of the spare material. That could be cool. So yeah, that would be actually a good idea. That's indeed something we actually thought about. We'll see exactly where we can put it. If you look at the table from the top, basically the space that is left where we could mount things, like where we could add threadings to mount things, that would be this space here. So we cannot really cut out too much here if we use that for threadings, but for sure those areas here at the top could be somehow cut it into something that could be made useful. So we'll that's definitely something we are considering, especially a lot of people are using water coolings. Even us in the world tour, we're using them. For example, if you look at that cooler here on the stream PC, that's how he's actually sitting on the base. So that's a Neptune 120 XL from Cooler Master, and basically it's just holding like
it's
this.
It's just old there. But so maybe
a nice little mount like this, indeed, it would not take much. So that's definitely something we're looking to adding to the more final revision, final revision.
The final. So that was a question on live chat from Droid Insanity. What are these two slit in the bottom four. Is that for front panel or for something else? And Timothee, I don't know if you can find a.
If you can grab my backpack, I have SSDs in there. Okay. If it's not too far for you.
So I will let you speak while I grab the.
Yeah,
the
sure.
SSD.
It's somewhere here on the side. My backpack. So basically, the way it works is that some kind of slots for hanging down. So basically, it hangs down here. You can hang your drives, 2.5 drives. So basically, you put your screws at the top. You just put it in there. It just fits in the hole there. So you can see it kind of slides at the top here. And then you take your SSD, which Trouffman just found so fast. It's amazing. Thanks for looking into my backpack.
Well, thanks for having an organized backpack.
Oh, yeah. And then, so basically, oh, wait. This magnet thing got to the drive. So basically, you just put the screw in there. It fits into the hole of your drive. Truth, your screwdriver is not very practical. It's actually too small, the head, so it's falling in down. All right, so you put your drive on top. Just hit the hole, and you just screw into your SSD drive. So then the drive just is hanging down there, and that's it. So I'm just gonna put one and just tighten it up. So it's kind of, I just need to put one, but basically you could put two. Actually, only one would be necessary if only SSDs had one screw in the middle. But you know, standards, right? So I'm gonna just put the second one just for fun. Basically, it goes like that. You just screw it in there, and that's it. Your drive is secured. You can just put the things. So, of course, things we thought about, and that was discussed with some overclockers in South Africa when we presented them the table last week, was to think of a way to actually slot in drives, because overclockers need sometimes to swap drives very quick. So it's not going to be very easy to do in that area, but maybe there could be some accessories we could think about later on. So that would probably bring us to the open part of the bench table, which is...
Yeah, what is it called open bench table? Just because it's open air or...
Because it has a lot of holes. No, actually, it's called open bench table because basically the design, once it's going to be final, will make available online the actual blueprints of the table, where people will be able to see where the threadings are, what's the dimensions and the spacing between each, and they will be able to build accessories for that table. So we are not going to make many accessories OSET. That's not the point. What we want is that overclockers that feel creative, that got some cool ideas of how to customize the table, have options on the table, so threadings in different places added to the design, where they can build accessories for. So those accessories can be, for example, 3D printed to the right sizes. They could be made out of aluminium as well, why not, etc. So people can make their own, sell them to their friends or somehow, or make a pre-orders together, Kickstarters for accessories or whatever, and customize the table basically. So we're talking, of course, about adding LEDs, because that's some kind of something fancy at the moment.
I want red LEDs.
But like, for example, what's suggested, you have the radiator mount. If someone has a 240 radiator that doesn't fit, or like one with 3x80 fans that is really large as long as the table, you might want to, you know, make a custom mounting. Maybe you want to have your radiator somewhere on the side of the table, so hanging down here. Hang it down here on the side, so you will just need some mounting pieces here at each edges to clip it on or something. Talking about clipping on, you will have stuff like for webcams or stuff you could want to attach here. So yeah, basically that's the whole idea of open. So we're gonna have that website, openbenchtable.com. The blueprints will be on there once they are final, and then people will be able to upload their own blueprints for accessories or anything they are building around the table, or even customization of the actual table. So if you think of a way to improve it, you can also post it on there. If it's really good and it really helps, we integrate it to the next version of the design. And that's it. So that's the whole idea of making it open. Open for customization.
Yeah, open for customization, open for usage. And that's the thing. These is a base for more tools to be used for by the overclockers. There's one thing the overclockers have, the extreme overclockers have always been struggling with. It's always messy on the desk. It's super difficult to have something very clean and sleek. And we do hope that with this kind of project and this kind of product, it will help a lot all of the people. Timothee, why did we use aluminium and not something else like some kind of plastic?
I don't like plastic. No, actually, it's
okay. That's not the right answer, but still,
I really love aluminium. It's very light. It's very strong, and it's also very easy to cut out CNC, dig holes into it, make anything you want. If you're using plastic, you have to make a mold. It's really expensive to make a mold for plastic, or you 3D print it, but then it's kind of not really great plastic. It's a kind of melted ABS that is layered and layered and layered. It's really hard to get something really consistent over several pieces. Also with aluminium, we're capable of making it relatively light for the amount of load it can actually take. So yeah, that was the main idea behind aluminium. And Streacom is specialized in aluminium, so it was just perfect.
Talking about the load it can sustain, life experience right there. When you did the special 4K, the ultimate frozen PC, yep. You were using one bench table on that, and there was like four-way SLI cooldown with the full pods. That was the CPU pod as well in there, and with the LN2 and the cold, after let's say like half a day of shooting, I can't remember how many hours that was, the benchtable was actually starting to burn.
Yeah,
this is not a benchtable that was available on the market anyway. That was a benchtable just a limited edition, but still it was still bending. So that's something you will not be able to use in the competition, that will not be able to use long term as well.
You know, no one wants to have a bench table where your system is on it, and when you start pulling LN2, you hear it crack from every corner. You know, it's definitely not good build. You can make bench table out of steel that can take good load, but the problem with steel is that it's very heavy for very little material, and it's the painting is always kind of tricky, especially if you apply very cold temperature to it, it might crack off. Steel is just not as great as aluminium for making threadings as well. If you want to make threadings into material for steel, like you need to have a whole plate of steel. It's gonna be so heavy.
It's gonna be so heavy, yeah. That's the trick.
Yeah, actually, it's funny because we are thinking about adding steel to the threading here. So some steel ringlets around, so the actual threading is made into steel, so because it's less soft than aluminium, but the rest of the table will be aluminium. So just steel holders there. Not sure exactly where for which, but that's something we are talking about.
This is still under discussion still, and there was a comment from Droid Insanity. You can do it out with styrofoam. Nope.
You can make it out of carbon fiber. That would be expensive. Even more expensive, out of titanium. Actually, titanium is really awesome as well. It's same kind of finish in material. It's used a lot for hiking equipment and things that needs to be very sturdy and solid and very light. So titanium, it's an option. Super awesomely expensive, but so far I think aluminium is the best.
I do prefer aluminium, but that's a personal opinion. And
you could do it out of acrylic as well, but that would be kind of more inclined to scratches, and I'm not sure about acrylic.
Super cold, yeah, I don't know how it will react under.
It's gonna shrink for sure. It's gonna maybe shrink differently than aluminium. But
that's a quite interesting product, and don't forget, guys, this is open, and we are taking the feedback. This is at the origin based on a community project, and we all want to hear from you guys to know what happened. Let's go back to quickly to all the main points that we had. So this is called the Open Benchtable. So this is the name of the project. We are taking comments if you have ideas and stuff you want to request for it. So far, the goal was to make something portable, usable, and light for every overclockers that do travel a lot. Of course, the usage will be compatible with any overclockers or reviewer, hardware reviewer, that want to have an open test bed that is directly, no, that is available just by them and quite useful to just use like this. Like, oh, I just want to unmount and go, or just want to go there and I don't have to unmount and take like a big box with me just to move the bench table. Traveling wise, you did travel with this. From Taiwan to South Africa and from South Africa to here in Europe with this in your backpack.
So I folded it back exactly like I took it out of the box, and I just put it into the back of my backpack right next to my laptop, and yeah, no problem at all.
No problem, security, everything was fine.
So only in Taiwan they asked me, so they could see in the x-ray, you know, when you pass the security, like TSA, they saw the standoffs, which were into that little casing compartment here. And they were asking me, so what is this? So I said, it's some screws. And then they were like, what? Screwdriver? No, not a screwdriver. Screws. And they're like, can we see? No, I need a screwdriver to open it, and it's not allowed on the plane, so I cannot open it. It's on screws. And then the guy said, oh, it's okay. And then at the other airport, I didn't have any issues, so no problem.
That's actually like the best test proof. It's a prototype, and you still managed to get them on there. So far, 2.5 kilos.
Yes.
2.5. I can't remember exactly how much.
2.2. The table itself is 2.2. 2.5 is with the acrylic and the boxing around it. So.
It's quite packed, and when we did receive the 12 bench table for this event here in Europe, we had two boxes straight from China. And these boxes were taking less space than all the memory kit that we had.
Yeah, it's surprisingly compact, and it's something we're not too used to with Benchtable, where it actually takes a whole pallet to ship eight of them to an event. So it's kind of nice to not have to worry about the volume of your Benchtable.
That's something you could get with you guys directly at the competition if you're an extreme overclocker competing here at the World Tour or any of the World Tour along this year. Regarding the design, it's all smooth and well-rounded and everything. We have to ally that these are the work at STREACOM. These guys knows how to design these kind of case. They know exactly how to design very high-end and good-looking product for that. Timothee, how was the experience with you working with STREACOM along this project?
So the story is that, so like we said, we met them at Computex last year. We presented the projects. So actually, we went first to see them to see what they have in product, because we always like to meet the guys on STREACOM. So we went to their meeting room in 101, and we were just talking, and then we're like, hey, you know what? Maybe we should work together on doing a bench table.
Yeah, because actually that idea came out like in a regular meeting, like chatting about like what they were doing with the case and so on. And the idea is like, you know what, a bench table would be cool. And they actually did jump on the idea as well. And that's it. Like less than a year after, we already have the prototype.
Yeah. So basically, once after we had that meeting, I just sent an email of a follow-up email. You know, one of those many emails you do at Computex, and I sent.
No, the main emails you send every day.
I just sent it. So I sent it to the two guys from STREACOM, and I was like, okay, hey, so this benchable, are you really interested into doing it? Do you want to work on the prototype? How you want to do something? How do you want to cooperate on that? We have this open benchtable project. Are you interested with that? You know, because you also have to find a company that is willing to put design hours and manufacturing for the prototypes. So it actually costs money to manufacture those. They're not cheap, and the less you do, the more expensive they are usually. So they were okay with that. They really liked the project. For them, what they wanted to show with this table is their capabilities as STREACOM to manufacture custom cases, their expertise in aluminium cases and customized CNC work and things like that. So we started working on the design. What I did, I sent them an email with basically all the specs, everything we wanted, saying, okay, it has to be able to carry that much load at maximum.
These are all the requirements we knew from traveling with a lot of overclockers to competition that we did gather over the time.
And that we had already listed for the Open Benchtable project. So we have those. We wanted to be able to at least have the standoffs for the PCI Express. Like you say, it needs to be able to be packed in a compact way. We hadn't thought about that shape. So packed in a compact way, it has to be able to be folded with as less screws as possible, something as standard as possible. We want people to be able to customize it, so that's something we're still working into doing. We also wanted to be able to show this table on the World Tour 2016. And that was a tight schedule. So the guys from Streacom say, okay, that sounds like it's something we can do. So they went to the drawing board and they made some drawings. We also had sent them some of the drawings we had made, but ours were not as good as the ones they did.
We are not designers.
And within a week or two or something like that, Simon, the guy from Streacom that is doing all the design and overseeing the manufacturing in China, came up with a 3D render of mainly something that is very similar to that, like almost as close as that. Then it was great. Like we just tweaked a few things, you know. But they really came up with that really cool design that is this one. And I totally loved the handle thing.
The handle thing is just perfect.
Yeah. With the legs into the chassis, that was just awesome. So the collaboration went really great. Then this, we made some revision on the design, discussed a few things, and then. They produced two pieces, so they kept one for them to test it, and they sent one to me in Taiwan. So as soon as I got it, I had basically one day to test it out and
take pictures, get the first feedback.
Yeah, and make a list of feedbacks I think we want to change or maybe tweak for the first batch of production. First batch of production was for South Africa, and sadly it was Chinese New Year in between. And things got a little bit tight, and in the end we didn't have the tables right in time for being delivered at the South Africa World Tour event. So I came with the one table I had there to show it to everyone, and so the tables for the winner of South Africa will be shipped later on. And but then for Gamers Assembly, so the event here in Europe, there was plenty of time to produce the extra ones. So here we got 12 tables delivered here within 24 hours by Streacom. Awesome work. And we're going to have 6 more for the North American event as well.
We have to highlight the fact that Streacom have been extremely responsive in this project. They have been extremely good at making sure the production is on time, making sure the production is super high quality. And I think that does help that the two main guys we are talking with, yeah, in Streacom are actually like checking. There's this one living in China at the moment. That's the only reason why he could not be here on the, yeah, on the live with us, because that's like almost 2 a.m. for him.
It's too bad because he's really an awesome guy, and he's amazing in design, and all the work he's doing is really great. Yes, Gapo, I would not recommend using the table to smuggle stuff. We don't want to give it a bad reputation. You can do what you want, but don't associate the table with it.
That was a question from Woody's Gun. Is there any estimate or price, or is this too early in development? I will straight away. These are still prototypes. These are not final product yet. We are far from a final product at the moment. We do estimate we are at like 22-25% of the project. I'm pretty sure that after the world tour here, we are already gathering a lot of feedbacks. The feedbacks from you guys here on the live on Twitch or on the YouTube comment, if you are watching this replay on YouTube. We will gather all that feedback to try to see if we can implement them or get into the needs that, yeah, have been expressed. And I think after after mid year this year, we will have more idea of what could be the price, when that could be released. And I say could, because there's always a budget interest in that. How many can we produce, for what price, for what use, and stuff like this. But you guys, yep, seems quite interested for it, and we love the project. We definitely love this project. So
actually, talking about production and quantities to produce and how much estimated of the demand and things like that, it's very important. If you like the design and you're interested into eventually buying one or winning one, go to the openbenchtable.com website and subscribe there with your email. Every single email we receive in there is basically not a commitment to purchase, but it's a commitment of interest. That's very helpful for us to know, okay, there's actually interest for the design, people are really liking the project. So that way we have your mail, we can keep you up to date with the eventual date of availability, when the what the pricing will be, how you can get yours. If we haven't figured out how we will do, you know, distributions and things like that. Do we?
This is gonna happen at the very end of the project.
Of course,
we are still at the design phase. These are prototypes.
Of course, but it's something you have to think about. So for sure, if people are interested already right now, they should leave down your email. And of course, you know, it's the type of project where the first arrived, it's something you want to give something special to. So if we do something special the day it comes out, it will be to those who subscribe first. So I would really highly recommend you guys to get into the list. That's always really appreciated to get all the support.
Well, I think that was a lot of information here. So if you want more information about this, it's openbenchtable.com, all in one word. If you can find that also on Facebook, open.benchtable, or facebook.com/openbenchtable. And if you want more information, you can always find these on the, you can always find all the information on Overclocking TV, HWBOT, or Facebook, or Streacom with the name Streacom BC1.
That makes me think there's going to be an official news announcement of the Benchtable with more pictures, etc., all that published on HWBOT, CTV and Streacom as a joint PR coming out Tuesday after the Easter weekend everyone is back.
Yeah, when everyone is going to be back to work. Thank you, Timothee, for all the time. Thank you guys for tuning in this live. And we do hope that you love as much as we do this Benchtable. And if you have any more information, we're going to be still on the live chat or in the comment on YouTube to answer all of your questions. Thank you very much for tuning in. We will see you again tomorrow for the second day of the HWBOT World Tour here in Europe at Poitiers in France in the Gamers Assembly. Until next time, keep pushing it.